and gentlemen, we continue on the road to Lashing Back 3 for another episode of Monday Night Raw. I am the Intercontinental Champion, Osterjax, and apparently joining me is Kanye West.
It'd be funny. No, it's Loud Styles.
Damn! In all seriousness, ladies and gentlemen, we've got a big triple threat main event planned for you. The three winners of last week's six-man tag match, Bobby Lashley, Triple H, and Christian, are set to collide tonight here in the main event. And it's definitely set to be a great show as we continue
on. It's going to be one hell of a night here on WEDF Raw.
And out comes none other than the WEDF Champion, Stone Cold Steve Austin. I've talked with a couple guys in the background, and there's some word going around that Austin is not the man to mess with right now. He's not happy about what happened to him on the last Raw in the main event, where he was forced to team up with The Miz and John Cena against Christian, Triple H, and Bobby Lashley. And The Miz actually bailed on Austin and Cena and left them at a handicap against the other three.
Well, you know what? It's no surprise that The Miz would do something like that. He cares for only one person, and that's himself. And let's not forget, he is a bit of a coward. But I'm just interested now in what Austin has to say about all what happened that last Raw.
No, he's the man who called for a six-pack challenge. He wanted a challenge at Lashing Back, and just seeing one of his challengers walk out on the match and not really try to prove his worth, I gotta think the Texas RattleSnake is definitely reconsidering the credibility of one of the challengers.
Telling it like it is.
Oh boy.
Austin being Austin and telling Miz what he can do.
And nonetheless, ladies and gentlemen, here comes the most mostly superstar in WEDF. Okay, wait, no, Frank Dog's not here.
Thank you.
We can be unbiased here tonight. The Miz, ladies and gentlemen, the awesome one, the former WEDF champion, making his way out to the ring. And I don't understand what Miz's deal is at all.
Well, all I can say is this is the first Raw I've seen where he doesn't have a fake tan.
Oh. Austin is not playing tonight, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, you do not piss Austin off and think you're going to get away with it.
I don't think Miz knows exactly what he's stepping into here.
Screwed.
He's claimed there's a conspiracy against him, and he's claimed that the match wasn't stopped when he was busted open, yet he still put up a fight, and yet Frank Dog still tried to help Miz keep the title at WrestleMania.
But failed.
So really, I think Turnabout has to be somewhat fair play here.
Turnabout is fair play.
You see Miz laying it all on the line here. As devious, as dastardly as what he's saying here, there is one thing that Miz is more focused on. He's not focused on the tag match. He's focused on Lashing Back. He wants the WEDF Championship. And so what he's trying to do is he's trying to preserve himself. But at the same time, Miz, you're going to catch ring rust. I hope you're aware of that.
I don't think he is, wait.
And Austin is not going to take kindly to that.
Awesome part, because Austin is about to beat the hell out of him.
Opening a can of whoop ass on The Miz right now, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, look at that, Austin, do what anyone do. Stomping a mud hole in his ass and walking it dry.
Oh my god, Austin beating the high holy hell out of Miz right now.
Miz is being beaten down like a government mule, but Miz! Now Miz putting up a fight, and I don't think Miz is taking kindly to this. Taking the fight right to the WEDF champion. Not intimidated by the Texas RattleSnake.
The first time I ever see, oh man, what a clothesline. The first time I ever seen The Miz actually fight back on something.
Miz has a lot of fire in him. That's Rowan right. Austin into the ropes. Miz! Right. No!
Oh, man. Neck breaker.
These two men are just having at it right now. This is chaotic right now, and this is absolutely a hell of a way to start off Raw and lay it into him with the Luthas press! And wait a minute, what?
He's too beaten out, and that's,
it's our WEDF security breaking them up and keeping those men apart! But right. I don't think they'll be able to keep them apart for long. These two men despise each other. These two men hate each other's guts. They want more of each other. I doubt Tony Chimmel and that referee, the women's champions, apparently, they're not going to hold him back much longer.
I don't know if they will either, but...
But up next, ladies and gentlemen, we are set to see the debut of the man who claims to have turned over a new leaf, the Southern Gentleman, Ted DiBiase, in action!
Ted DiBiase, the Southern Gentleman, making his way towards the ring, and I don't know if I can honestly believe he turned over a new leaf.
Well, you know, he came over from ECCW, just came out of a big, big rivalry with his former legacy partner, the dashing Cody Rhodes, against the team of Smokey and the Wu-Tang Man. And Ted DiBiase, he said once he came to Raw, he said, you know, I've made a lot of mistakes. I've done a lot of bad from ECCW. I don't want to be like that. I want to change my ways. I want to prove to these people that I'm a great wrestler. I want to prove to these people that I'm a good man. And I want to prove that the new Ted DiBiase is here to stay, and the new Ted DiBiase is someone you can all trust. And he's going to get his chance against the Sinister Scotsman, the chosen one of the WEDF, Drew McIntyre. Now back to DiBiase quickly as McIntyre is going to make his entrance. Ted DiBiase, I like the fact that he has some humility to come out and admit his wrongdoing. But as I'm going to say right here, and as everybody will tell Ted DiBiase, respect is earned, not given.
That is true.
And this man right here, he could honestly care less. The oldest, cold eyes of the Scottish-born Drew McIntyre. This man, ladies and gentlemen, he has a hell of a future here on Raw. And as you saw on his first match as a Raw superstar officially, he took none other than the Viper, Randy Orton, the inaugural WEDF champion, to his limit and then some. Put on a hell of a match with him all the way back to the draft. So I gotta think, Drew McIntyre, ladies and gentlemen, is going places.
Drew McIntyre is indeed going places with that ruthless aggression, that just vicious streak with him, and the fact that he's one of the most athletically gifted men here in WEDF. He's got all the tools to be a champion.
Yes, but does he have the wisdom? Does he have the decisions? Does he have the attitude of a champion? That will remain to be seen, but there is one thing going for Drew McIntyre, love him or hate him. This man was personally signed to one of the most lucrative contracts in WEDF history by none other than our WEDF chairman of the board, Vincent Kennedy McMahon.
That's right, Vince McMahon signed Drew McIntyre because he saw something in Drew McIntyre.
Now McIntyre and DiBiase slowly getting started off in the middle of the ring. An exchange of wrestling holds between these two, and DiBiase with a beautiful backbreaker.
It was a very nice modified backbreaker there.
Drew McIntyre is not looking too happy about it, but DiBiase is not backing down from the fight.
Drew punching away. DiBiase with a punch of his own. These two just exchanging blows in the middle of the ring.
Trading soup bones, as a certain commentator might say. DiBiase now getting on fire after catching one of Drew's hands. Right jabs of his own. DiBiase, a beautiful drop kick from the Southern Gentleman.
Very nice drop kick.
And now DiBiase getting on fire. A big, big lariat. And DiBiase.
Oh, very dirty there. And oh, look at this. Back suplex.
Simple but effective backdrop suplex from DiBiase. No! Drew McIntyre.
Jesus.
Did you see the pop on that? Drew McIntyre just absolutely, I don't know how to put it, but that was a thing of beauty with that power slam.
I think he's going to give Randy Orton a run for his money when it comes to power slams.
Now Drew McIntyre just really taking the fight to the outside, where this could honestly benefit Drew McIntyre. The man is a fighter. The man is a brawler. I would think when we're fighting outside, Drew McIntyre has the advantage.
That's right, because he can use every part of that arena to his doing. Wait a minute, look at this.
Oh my goodness, a beautiful face buster from Drew McIntyre.
Damn, he just, I don't even know what to say. That was just a thing of beauty, but it was also vicious at the same time.
He just dumped him like he was yesterday's trash.
Exactly what he did, and now McIntyre, DiBiase back out of the ring, and
again to the outside, like Loudon said, using every part of the ring arena to his advantage.
McIntyre with that nasty boot, and now throws him back into the ring.
DiBiase, no pun intended here, he's literally on Dream Street right now.
Yes, he is, and oh my god, another!
The Sinister Scotsman is just laying in the Ted DiBiase here. I don't feel that the Fortunate Son's chances are very good in this match. As Drew McIntyre goes to make the quick cover. One, two, no! DiBiase kicks out.
Oh, man. I think he kicked out on fumes on that one.
Oh, but there is one thing that does need to be brought up. Drew McIntyre was formerly in a team called, I believe, the Chosen Warriors with Sheamus, and they were mentored by one of the toughest son of a bitches in all of professional wrestling, Fit Finlay.
He is one of the most vicious men in wrestling. And wait a minute, look at this.
DiBiase now with a quick cover to Drew McIntyre, not quick, counter, quick DDT counter, not cover, counter, excuse me, ladies and gentlemen. But DiBiase on fire right now with those atomic drops.
But you were talking about Fit Finlay mentoring both Sheamus and Drew McIntyre. But here's the thing. Drew McIntyre was also the person that retired Finlay.
Absolutely. The student surpassed the master. Drew McIntyre does not seem to have learned from his teachings. But hey, you never know. Now that he's on Raw with a new life, with new blood, with new challengers, more opportunities could open up for Drew McIntyre. But there you see what a dastardly trick as he rolled out of the ring to avoid any punishment from DiBiase. Dirty but effective, almost gave him the advantage, but DiBiase quickly turning the tables once again. Now DiBiase throwing him in the corner. McIntyre with a counter, another big boot!
Jesus, oh no.
Wait a minute, is he setting up for the future shock?
Oh, yes. Oh, no.
That is a DDT, though, but that was not the Future Shock DDT. But Drew McIntyre just dissecting. Oh, my goodness, a flatliner. The flatliner. A flatliner style maneuver from Drew McIntyre as he makes the cover. One, two, no.
Oh, man, how close was that?
That was awfully close. And really, Drew McIntyre, when he had the chance, he should have put Ted DiBiase away when he could have hit the Future Shock DDT. Had DiBiase perfectly dazed, had him in perfect position, but did not finish the job.
I think he's just toying with DiBiase right now.
Exactly what he's doing, as you see him just strutting right now.